Thanks, Lauren. Well, a Fort Myers man who dropped everything to defend his people, his religion, and his home is now home for good. I met Logan Aleph in October as he was heading to Israel to fight Hamas. Well, now we talked about life after war.
In Logan Aleph's home, 5-year-old Lila is the drill sergeant.
Do I fix it?
She picks out the games, the players.
Only these persons.
Oh.
Sometimes it's a battle.
What about the Lincoln Log?
That is not even a toy.
But it's a battle Logan would gladly fight every second of every day.
Baby, I love you. Life is a joy.
Because Logan knows there's no joy in a real war zone. There's no love, no hugs. Not from his little girl, not from his wife, Sarah. Logan told me war is evil.
You know, you can't make a cartoon comic book villain more evil than Hamas.
On October 7th, Hamas terrorists crossed the Gaza border into Israel, tortured, raped, and butchered hundreds of Israelis, people living in the place where Logan grew up, the place his family, his friends, still call home.
The worst vicious animals don't do things like this.
Logan served in the Israeli army once before and felt it was his duty to serve again.
You have to protect your family. And that's the whole guiding motivation.
While fighting Hamas, Logan and I stayed in touch. He told me things were bad, but he couldn't tell me how bad until now.
But for the first 3 weeks, we were very, very, very busy. There were a lot of still roaming bands of terrorists in the south. There were still a lot of unrest. And as part of the Special Forces Border Police, we went down to the south, you know, we're capturing and arresting Hamas terrorists.
Logan told me when his unit got word there was a Hamas terrorist to track down.
Boom, it's go time, ready to go. You know, ran in, grabbed the guy, arrested him. We know he's armed. We know his intent, but how do we have the operation where we don't have any harm to civilians? We get him and only him. So there's a lot of waiting involved.
The waiting was rarely quiet. There were rockets with sirens.
Constantly, constantly.
And so was missing Lila and Sarah.
Sarah counted every single day, 7 weeks.
Afraid for her husband because she knew he was surrounded by so much death.
You know, I've lost 18 people that I know personally.
Finally, on Lila's 5th birthday, Logan came home. What was supposed to be a surprise turned into a welcome home.
My wife did say, "You're never doing that again." So I'm never doing that again.
And now Logan is at peace. He knows his family in Israel is safe and that he did his duty.
Our chapter is done and we get to move on with our lives.
Thankfully, Logan's got a heck of a commander.
Final touch.
To show him the way.
Logan told me he was honored to serve his country and he is so relieved that his family in Israel is safe. But as you heard him say, he does not plan to go back. Instead, he is focused right here at home on being the best dad and the best husband he could possibly be.